Well, hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty, of course, and I haven't been doing many art videos. I know it's kind of lame, but I just haven't been doing any art lately that I've really wanted to show off. But I've been working on my stop motion again. It's the Wolf's Heart. It's a project I was working on like a year ago, and I kind of stopped. I don't remember why. I think it was the weather, which is kind of funny because here I am starting again when it's cold. But I just thought, you know, I may as well make some videos about the stop motion again. People seem to like them, so here's where I'm at. I'm working on this tower right here. This is actually the roof. If you come down here, right in this area, if you kind of go back and watch the movie, it's kind of where I ended with my character. He was like sitting right here, and that's sort of the background. And I need a shot that kind of raises up like this to that window way up there. And the character is going to kind of climb up these rafters, go over to the window. And I'm just filling in all these rafters right now. I'm just filling in all the beams so that he's got stuff to climb on, and the whole thing looks cool. And I'm making them out of 1x2s, and these ones are just kind of the ones I already made and pillaged together. And after I get them all into the right spots, I'll tape them all up, texture them, and paint them. So anyway, let's get going. So I'm working on this top one right here. There's like going to be one that flat goes across there, and then there's going to be one that shoots up there. So I cut one across here, and then the way I attach these is I actually make a mark right there, and then I drill through to the outside, and then I actually throw a screw back this way. Over here. So when I drilled through, I actually broke that little rock off of there. And there's the hole right there. But that's actually not a big deal, because I just kind of save these things, and then I hot glue them back in the spot. I've knocked a few off here and there. Like, here's another one. You know, I just kind of save them in a little stack, and I just hot glue them back on. They don't really need to go back in the same position. And then, like, when I right before I shoot, I actually kind of just touch the setup with some paint. You know, I always do that anyway, just because, you know, things get dinged and stuff. I put all this stuff together with screws, like you can see. And I like that a lot, because it's like you can take pieces out if you need to. If you do something wrong, you can take it back out, unscrew stuff, screw it all back together. Like this piece here was actually a little tight. It didn't quite want to fit over underneath this one, so I took it out and I trimmed that down a little. Now I'm just screwing it back in, so it's just kind of handy. So like, these are all just 1x2, you know, just the cheapest 1x2 pine that you can get at like Home Depot. And when I screw them all together, how I don't just crack them all the pieces is I pre-drill holes. I just use a small bit like this one here, if you guys can see that. Any old size, that's just a little bit smaller than the screw. And then I just pre-drill all the holes, and I just stick a screw down in there, and that, you know, keeps it from, gives it just enough that it won't crack stuff apart. So I just got these ones up. You can see I repurposed that one from some of the old rafters. Now I'm going to do this one in the front here. I was looking around and I actually found this one, which is one of the old rafters, like a full piece. And I was thinking, if I set it like this, let me get back for it if you guys can see. See what I mean? If I just take out that bottom board, I can use this top bit, and it'll make the configuration I want. So I'm gonna do that. All right, so all the rafters are done. And I was just sitting here thinking about what the next step is, kind of writing down my kind of schedule in the notebook. So the next thing is to paint and tape the rafters. And then I need to make something black behind that window so it looks like there's night out there. Which that won't be too hard, just a piece of paper probably at this point. I need to glue up whatever rocks fell off and give the set a quick touch up. And then I'm going to be kind of getting into a little bit of a time thing, because on my camera, on my good camera, I had to order another, basically like the power supply, so you can plug it in, because you can't really shoot animation off a battery. You don't want your camera turning off at some random time and you have to mess around with the camera getting a new battery in. So you basically have to be able to plug it into a wall. So anyway, I had one of these things, but it actually kind of burned out. It stopped working, so I had to order another one. So I ordered another one a couple days ago off of eBay, and I found like a U.S. seller this time, so it would hopefully get here in a decent amount of time and not a month from China. So I really need like a working camera so that I can put it on the rig here and then light the set, because I, you know, when I light the set, I like to look to the camera and then see how the light looks. So hopefully that won't slow me down too bad. And then basically I need to do some animation in this set I've made. That's not going to be the full episode. There's like, I guess there's two sets in this episode. So I'm going to have to strike this set once this is done and then put up the next one. But, that's kind of where I am now. So, man, I'm like really close to actually doing some more animation, which is almost a little scary. But anyway, so the next step is tape and paint the rafters. So I got some time today, so I'm going to go ahead and start doing that. All right, I'm taping the rafters. I don't know if you guys remember that, but when I make the rafters, I just kind of like run a piece of tape on there, kind of all messed up to make all the wrinkles. And then I run just a new piece of tape, like this, and then when I paint it looks like wood. It's like it's the same thing I did on the floor of my last set. So if you want to really research it, you can go watch that video. I got them all taped, as you can see. Whoops, forgot this one. Got to tape that one still. All these little wrinkles will make the make all the ridges. And I want to glue on some of the rocks, and I want to start painting. I want to show you this real quick. We picked up this little kerosene heater for the shed, and man, it's like really warming it up in here, which is really nice. So I was kind of worried about what I was going to do this winter. The only thing about it is it's got a little flicker. You can see the flame and stuff. So I obviously can't have it sitting near the set. I'm going to have it sitting back kind of with something in front of it. But it's kicking off like a ton more heat than like those little electric heaters. Those little electric heaters just couldn't keep up with it out here. So this is good. This is kind of solves a problem I had, which was animating when it was cold out here, or just working when it was cold out here, just like now where I want to paint these rafters. You know, it's just like, it's hard to paint when it's cold. The paint doesn't want to dry and stuff, so. This is my collection of rocks that I've sell off, and the heat gun. I'm using the bigger one. This one gets a little bit hotter. It's got an adjustment here, high and low. All I do is just kind of try to figure out which goes where. I think that actually might be the one that goes there. That's kind of incredible. I grabbed that one. Just kind of dry fit it. And give it a little swirl. And I just glue it on there. There's that one. There we go. So just using my brush, just throwing in like a black wash on everything. I'm being real careful to, you know, get all the edges, look underneath, see like right there. When I got the camera going, you know, there's going to be all kinds of angles on this thing, so it needs to be painted pretty much everywhere. I'll throw a little bit of an edge right there too, just to blacken that out. I don't know if that part's going to be seen. I don't think it is, but it's like right on the border, so you never know, it might sneak in somewhere and then it catches you. Now for the rafters, I think it's hard to remember how I paint some of this stuff. It's good why I make videos, because I can go back and watch my own videos. and kind of remember. But I think with the Raptors, I just kind of washed on a real loose black. I didn't paint them completely black, and then I just wiped it off. And then came in with some brown, and then that worked out. So I'm just doing like a real wet wash to start. Sort of like that same black paint I used on the walls. And then before it's even dry, I'm just kind of wiping most of it off. I'm just not wiping at all. I'm just kind of giving it a little bit of a wipe. And the stuff that hits the walls, it's not a big deal because I'm going to be touching the walls up real quick too. Just like that. So then I mixed up a little of this kind of burnt sienna kind of brown. And I'm just kind of lightly, just real watery, just real kind of watery, giving it one of these deals. Then I hit it with the hairdryer a little bit, and then I kind of just take a rag and just knock it back a smidge. Take off some of it. And they match up pretty well. So for the walls, I mixed up a little black and white. Just a touch of blue. Not hardly anything. And then I just use a pretty good sized brush. And I'm just kind of using this cardboard down here. And I just kind of brush all of the, most of the paint off. And then come back up to where I'm painting. Oh, that's even a little too much there. Just like take almost all of it off. And if it's looking too bright, just wipe it with the rag or something. That looks like about perfect though to me. Oh, this is kind of the part where I want to stop hitting stuff. And I kind of blend it out too whenever I'm trying to match something so that it doesn't look like I painted just one spot, you know. Put a little bit here and there. That's all it takes. Just bringing these rocks back to life. Just do it real dry. You know, just do it, barely go over it, and then if you need more paint, go back for more paint. It's easier to put more than take off. There's that hole I drilled by mistake. Actually looks kind of like it's supposed to be there. I think I'm going to leave it. And this kind of has, if you can look real close, a little bit of white spatter, a little bit of black spatter. Probably come back and I'll do that. Match it up a little bit better. So there it all is. It's all painted up. I got all the rafters done. Looks pretty good. The last thing I want to do is actually paint the floor black. Because he's going to start, the action is going to start on this rafter. And I'm afraid that some of that brown is going to just mess my lighting up. Because on the last episode, you know, the lighting was very blue. And I just want that same kind of lighting for the next episode, of course. So So it's the next day, and there's how the floor turned out. Looks pretty good. I actually got Tanya's computer in here, and I'm going to set up the camera. I actually got the dummy battery that I was talking about in the mail this morning, so there that is. It just goes inside there, and I'll take it out and show it to you. So there it is right there. It's just a battery that goes inside the camera. Here's the camera right here. I'm trying to do all this one-handed, so there it goes there. See how it is? Just slides in there like that. Just click it down in there. There's a little flap right here on your camera that can go through. And Tanya's computer just went to sleep. That was what that sound was. And then you can fire it up. And you can see, let me show you the rest of it. So it goes to an AC adapter. And then over here's the plug. So you can plug that camera into just a wall outlet and it'll just keep going continuously. So it's a really handy thing for stop motion. It's like time to light the set. So that's what I'm getting ready to do. And that's why I have Tanya's computer out here, so I can fire up Dragon and get a good idea of like what it's actually going to look like. So I might as well show you guys the setup here. So this is my homemade rig. It travels up and down. Made it in another video. You guys can, you know, if you want to figure out how to make one, go check that out. And then I just got this little swivel head, which is real handy. It's got a quick release mount, which is right there. So you can just slide that in there. Anyway, there it is right there. I turned it around so it's on the right side. Then the cord plugs into the cord on the floor. And the other cord is one of these deals, which is just a cable that you use to download photos. You see there's a port right in there that you just plug this thing straight into. And then of course it's just USB straight to your computer. And then I start up Dragon Stop Motion, which is my drug of choice as far as animation programs go. It's a really great program if you can afford to get it. It's definitely worth getting. Okay, it just came up. And then you got live view to animate with, which is amazing. See, where's my hand? There it is. Alright. I actually brought the puppet out too so I could, you know, get a reference, you know, have him in the scene as I light the thing. So I usually light everything with these simple can lights, and these are like LED bulbs. And I don't really do like the photo lights and all that kind of stuff. A second light that I use are these little ones I make, and they're these LED flashlights from like Walmart or, you know, places like that. You see it's all taped together, and I put on a AC adapter, just some random one, and just wire them up so that they, you know, they shoot, and they work great as like little spots and things like that, you know, because like everything in stop motion is scaled down, so you got like puppets that are this big, so if you put a light bulb next to them, you know, it's like this big, you know, that's like the equivalent of like me having this gigantic bulb like next to me, you know. So, like, what's kind of cool about these little spots is, I mean, that's closer to, like, a, you know, a spot you would actually have in a movie pointing at an actor, you know. They got the puppet sitting up in the rafters again. That wasn't the exact pose he was in, but as you can see, he's down here on the camera. But it's like I'm wondering if I'm actually going to have to move this unit kind of like back. I might have to build a little platform or something so this sits further back, because like I don't have any shorter lenses than this zoom right here, and that's only taking it back this far. And as you guys can see, that's a pretty tight shot right there. I'm thinking I might want more of a shot. I'm starting kind of with one light. I got one down there, and then I just kind of build out from there. And try not to get too complicated. You gotta see what's going on. Focus up, camera, come on. I'm gonna give him that blue spookiness. I got two lights at this point, kind of shining up. Something kind of like that, which is pretty much the way I think I had him lit when he was sitting there. He was a bit underlit, and then there was something just giving that rim kind of light. So now the key is going to be like consistently lighted all the way till it gets up there, which is going to be tough. So, oh, there goes the heater. As soon as I sit down and start recording, here comes the heater. But I was just editing the video up. I think I'm going to end it there. That was about 4 days worth of work. I think I'm going to try to upload these videos again like on Fridays like I used to do. And see how that works. Keep going with the progress of the project. I was just sitting here looking over my puppet and just kind of looking at some of the wear and tear. There he is. But just on some of the hands, you know, some of the
paint. You can kind of see it starting to peel a little bit around the fingers, the fingernails and stuff. You guys getting a good view of that? There's my, sorry. Little midnight snack there.
And I'm watching C.B. Smallwood. I don't know if anybody watches his videos. He's one of the 100 Days of Comics guys. He's doing his 100 days. Dang camera, the battery died on me just when I was talking. But this guy, C.B. Smallwood, he just, he's doing the 100 Days of Comics. I know this got nothing to do with stop motion. But it's like, I love guys like this because they just don't quit, you know. I've been catching his videos whenever he puts them up. But it's like, you know, he's been doing this 100 Days of Comics. I think he's been doing it like for 300 days or something. Just when you think he's not going to go on with it, he puts another video up. And he's on, what, day 96 now? And, you know, he's just still fighting through it. And it's cool, you know. It's like what it takes to like, do these dang projects after work and all that kind of stuff. Anyway, he deserves some more subscribers. What's he got, 198? You guys should actually go and check out his channel. He's got some pretty good videos. So anyway, that's it. Hope you enjoyed the video. See you guys next time.